Hello, friends. My name is Cody, and I look after developer relations here at LaunchDarkly. And in today's video, we're going to take you on a tour of a few of the common ways that teams are using LaunchDarkly to totally change the way that they ship software inside of their environments. We're going to explore these capabilities in an application that we call Toggle Outfitters, a store application that is going to be going through some major changes. We're going to show you our core five use cases, things like risk-free releases and how you can use LaunchDarkly to dramatically reduce the risk of anything going wrong with your software release. We're going to show you technology migrations and how you can adopt things like new APIs, new databases, migrate to cloud using LaunchDarkly. We're going to talk about targeted experiences and how you can move beyond targeting off of users, targeting off of any property, maybe the hardware, maybe the region it's coming in from, and how you can customize the experience of users coming into your application. We're going to talk about how you can take all these capabilities and measure how effective they are. Measure how users are using your features, if they're meeting the goals that your business has set out. And finally, we're going to take all of this and explain how it matters in a mobile-first world, when the application is more than just a website. It's actually something installed on the device, and how you can reclaim control of your application using LaunchDarkly. Let's get into it. As we move through this demo, I want you to think about what this would look like inside of environments like yours, the rollout pipelines that would take place, the rollbacks when something would go wrong, the 2 a.m. conference bridges, the change control, all the new code you would have to push. Think about every time you would have to change this application, the process you would go through, and compare that to what it looks like using LaunchDarkly and managing it all with feature flags. Here we have Toggle Outfitters, a store application that's releasing a new digital storefront. I'm going to hit this first feature flag and turn it on, and we'll see that nothing changes inside of the application. That's because I've controlled the entire release with a LaunchDarkly feature flag that I've targeted only at my dev testers. This allows me to create risk-free releases by testing in production first. I can test against specific groups, controlling my blast radius and ensuring that only the people I want to experience the new change are going to experience it. When I click on login, I come in as one of those dev testers from this group, and I'm able to see the change, but nobody else is able to. I can now go through and start testing out the functionality of my site and confirming that it's working the way I expect. Being able to instantly roll out a change into an environment and control the blast radius is one half of the equation of managing risk completely inside of an environment. Let's see what happens when we roll out the next feature inside. I'm going to roll out our new billing UI. And we can see our application updated again. But when I go in and start clicking on purchasing, I'm getting an error message. The other half of creating risk-free releases is being able to instantly disable broken code. I can come in and toggle this feature off, and that problem code is removed from execution completely. Fortunately, I've already scoped this change down to only the users that I wanted to experience it, but I have the ability to control that completely inside of LaunchDarkly. I did that change manually by turning it off, but I can also automate that using a flag trigger. Flag triggers let us integrate the ability to turn on or off features with any APM tools inside of your environments, tools like Datadog or Honeycomb or New Relic, to be able to, again, turn off a feature based on events coming through. And if you want more integrations, you can use a generic trigger and tie it into things like CI/CD or other workflow tools to automate the way that you're turning on and off things inside of an environment. These two capabilities, the idea of being able to roll out a change quickly and disable broken code, is how the teams at Vodafone were able to move from the single digits to releasing over 355 times a month inside of their environments. Since we were able to disable this instantly, our dev team was able to troubleshoot hands-free what was going on inside of the environment without the pressure of an outage hanging over their shoulder. Ultimately, we have two features that control this capability. One is our UI change, and the other is a backend change in a separate API. We're able to control those from the same LaunchDarkly user interface. Since these two features are connected to each other, I'm going to create a flag prerequisite that says this can only be turned on when the migration one is turned on as well. I've set that to true, and I'll turn this functionality back on, and we'll see the application doesn't change at all because its dependent flag isn't on yet either. Now, ultimately, I mentioned this a moment ago, we want to be able to migrate this to a new set of APIs, our billing system APIs, and we want those to be highly scalable, and we don't want to build a store ourselves. We want to consume that capability. So we're going to use Stripe for this. This feature flag allows me to migrate those APIs over to Stripe, but I'm able to get very granular and only migrate the systems that I want to. This lets me avoid the nightmare of Big Bang migrations by giving me full control over it and making it into manageable blocks. In this case, I'm targeting off of my region, US West. I want to roll this out globally, specifically by region. I'm doing this different from targeting only users inside the environment. I'll go ahead and turn this functionality on and save the change, and we'll watch our application update again now. Now, when I go in and begin to click, everything is working, and I'm able to see my application starting to add items to the cart. So the store is working as we would expect it to. From here, I can manually start to expand this out to other regions. I can start with Central, go to East, and then go overseas to the UK. I could also do this as a percentage rollout, gradually rolling it out to percentages of those groups that are defined here in the segment. If I wanted to automate this, I could come in and use a workflow to drive that, doing a progressive rollout by percentage overall until it reaches 100%, or I can do a custom workflow where I integrate things like change control with approvals, flag changes. All of these are part of giving you full control over how you migrate to new technologies using LaunchDarkly. So we're happy with our store functionality now, and we want to be able to roll out a new centralized database. Database migrations are scary because if they go sideways, you lose all of your data potentially. With LaunchDarkly, you can control the risk of that. In our case, we're going to migrate table by table. We don't have to migrate the entire database at once. We can migrate those individual tables. I'm going to do the same regional rollout that I did before here. And when I turn on this functionality, I could choose to request an approval to make sure that change control is followed. And I can even schedule out the change if I wanted to a specific date and time. I'm going to go ahead and submit this change, and we can watch as the application updates instantly with the newly migrated database. I'm able to see my total inventory and outstanding orders on the left as well. This process is how the teams at Nestle Purina were able to migrate to AWS without any downtime. They're able to take hundreds of applications and ship them into cloud, having full control over the risk of how they rolled out, and again, doing that with no downtime. Now, we're very happy with the progress of our store. Teams are able to come in and purchase toggles from us. We're able to see the centralized database, but we want to be able to continue to innovate and release new capabilities to our users. We want to add new products and services, but we want to test those out before rolling that to everybody. We want users to be able to self-opt into that. And what we're going to do is we're going to enable this new product experience access feature. This one has a segment that's for beta users who are willing to test out our new capabilities. I'll save our changes, enable them. And when I join our early access program, we'll see the new products and services are available. We're now selling goggles as well. Let me get this nice banner on top to highlight the new items that are on sale. You can use LaunchDarkly in this way to target specific experiences at users. This isn't your typical feature that you'd roll out. It's a new product that you want to make available to specific teams, maybe premium users inside of an environment. In this case, we're targeting off of a specific property, but consider if you wanted to roll out new products to a specific region first using the regional targeting I did before. Or maybe you're not a store. Maybe you're a streaming provider like Hulu, who needs to roll out new capabilities to specific hardware, not even an identity inside of the application itself, but an actual physical component. They use LaunchDarkly targeting to roll out to more than 59 million users specific capabilities. We're really happy with the new functionality and the new products in our store, but we don't know for sure if people are consuming them in the way that we want to. This is where experimentation from LaunchDarkly comes in. With experimentation, we can very quickly measure the way features are being used inside of our product. Are they being consumed? Are these new items being used? In our case, we've built an experiment around the header. We want to see what words on the top of each one of these cards result in more people getting attention on them and purchasing. We've got an experiment built here that cycles through four different versions of the card and presents those to the users and measures which ones are being interacted with. When I go in and take a look at the results, I get data on which one of these is being consumed the most. Within our environment, we can see special is the one being consumed most often, but we also have the ability to put guardrail metrics on this to understand if we're impacting other items with this change. With LaunchDarkly, you get the ability to measure any feature this way, measure the performance of it, measure the revenue potential of it. And these capabilities are how CCP Games was able to use LaunchDarkly to measure session time within their gaming platform and ensure that the features they were releasing were ultimately translating to more people using those platforms. And when we think about mobile devices, we think about how much this changes. If I roll out a change, I just have to refresh this application and I get the new web UI. But when it comes to mobile devices, we're shipping these capabilities out to the end user's devices. We don't always know if those devices are going to have the updated software on them or not. So ultimately, having control within that application is incredibly important. And LaunchDarkly gives you that control. Consider when you roll out a change, are you able to coordinate today between the iPhone store or the Android store? LaunchDarkly gives you a tool to be able to synchronize those changes and release on your own terms, dictating when those items will be released to your end users. And more importantly, when there's a problem, being able to roll it back and turn it off, instantly recovering those applications that have already been shipped to end users. We can also use these same targeting capabilities that I've highlighted in here to target experiences at any type of device, whether it's Android device, iPhone device, tablet, the choice is yours. This capability is how the teams at Bayer ClimateView were able to coordinate their mobile releases to their mobile devices inside of their environment. I hope you enjoyed seeing a few examples of how teams are using LaunchDarkly to roll out changes like this into their environments. If you have any questions, we'd love to hear from you. Feel free to reach out anytime.